today I want to talk about preparing our hearts.
Okay.
Okay. Preparing. Oh. I started to move it, but I was told to stay. I'm gonna obey. I'm gonna obey. Okay. So it says, let every heart prepare. How do we prepare for the Lord? How do we prepare our hearts? Okay? I want to start with a song that many, many Christians and non-believers, they sing every year. Okay? What's that song? Deck the halls. Okay? The halls. Deck. Deck the halls. Decorate. You're just making it beautiful. Okay? So, why decorate the halls? Why? Well, the song tells us tis the season to be jolly. Okay? So, what I want to do, two things. I want to define the words of the song and then search for the truth. Okay? So, define the words in the song and then search for the truth. All right? You ready? You're gonna go with me on this journey?
Yep.
Here we come. It says, tis the season. Okay, tis. You see that little apostrophe at the top before the T? It's saying, it means that one letter is missing. Okay? What letter that? I. It means it is the, all right? It is the, okay? So, we understand it?
Yeah.
It. What's it? Now. Now. Okay? Now. Now is the season. It says season. What does it mean? It means, okay, we have four seasons. We have spring, summer, fall, winter. Okay? So, those are four seasons, but it can also mean a special time in the year or of the year. Okay? So, it would say, come on, I'm waiting for you. Oh, if I go back, you can add ing to season. You have seasoning. What's that? Spices, right? You. Okay? So we're to be what? Salt and light. We add flavor to this world. Amen? Christians, they add, increase the flavor of life. Amen? That's awesome. All right. So. All right. So, let's look at this time, this time of the year. So this is a special time of the year, right? So let's look at it. We're in December, okay? December is the last month, okay? Is it usually warm, hot, what?
Cold!
It's usually cold. We're like, more, right? Freezing, okay? And so it's winter. It's cold, not hot, not warm, not, all right? So it's a special time when things, they die, right?
Right.
Things, if you don't die, can't live, right? If we don't die to ourselves, can't live in Christ.
Right.
Can't. Okay? So a few things that happen during this time. What? Christmas, Hanukkah, and then there's a black holiday. No, he said Black Friday, but it's called Kwanzaa. In the black communities, they have this celebration, okay? So there are many, many other things that happen. But these three are the biggest, okay? Now, even though the trees, they lose their leaves, the grass, it changes to brown, it doesn't matter. The snow, it covers the ugliness, right? Just like the blood of Jesus, it covers our sins. Amen. Now, let's see what we know. So truth, right now. Now is a special time of the year. Is that true? Okay, so right now, so far, it's all true, right? Okay, all right. Okay, so then it says, stay with me, Brandon. Now is the season, time, special time to be jolly, jolly. Is this a time of the year we should be jolly? All right, let's see. So, meaning of jolly. Let's see. Jolly means full of happiness and joy. Is it true?
Yeah.
This year, every person full of happiness and joy?
No,
not true. Not true. Many people are sad. They're grieved. Maybe a person they love died during this time, this special time of the year. Maybe divorced. Maybe a baby died. Maybe they got thrown out of their home. It's a sad, heartbreaking time. Not full of happiness. Not full of joy, but full of bitterness and sadness, heartbreak. So, because it's a special time of the year, does not mean that people are jolly, full of joy. not. Sure. God wants us to have peace, happiness, joy every day, all the time. But if we don't know Jesus Christ, can't be happy, joyful all the time. Can't. If you don't have brothers and sisters in the Lord to encourage and lift you up, can't have happiness and joy. The word, does it say that this special time is full of happiness and joy? Does the word of God say it?
Yes.
It's possible in the Lord. Without the Lord, can't. It's impossible.
Amen.
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 Let's look at the Word of God. Galatians chapter 4, verses 4 and 5, it says, but when the right time came, God sent his son, born of a woman under the law. God sent him to buy back our freedom. We were slaves under the law. He now can adopt us and make us his children. Now, because of Christ. That's good news. Amen. John chapter 3, verse 16, it says, now this is how God loved the world, that he gave his one and only son, so that everyone on the earth who believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life.
Yeah.
That is good news.
Yeah.
Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14, it says, all right, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the virgin will conceive a child. He will be born the Son of God and call his name Emmanuel, meaning God with us. Look, this is good news.
Yeah.
Because whatever is happening in our lives, God is with us, never leaving us, never forsaking us. God is here. Amen? So God, he became a baby, flesh, blood, born on the earth. Amen?
Amen.
Now look, I say it all the time, because maybe one day your heart will understand it truly, the deepness of this truth. God who created everything, every star we see in the sky. God, Almighty, Holy God, He, a big God, not a little God. No one can make God. The heavens, they can't hold or house God. I'm talking about a God. Not little. Not living in heaven. Can visit heaven, yes. Can look in and on the earth, can. But he's bigger than the heaven. Us understand this story that God, our big God, he was sitting on his throne, he looking down, humbling himself to see the things that are in the heavens and on the earth. He's humbling himself to see this small creation, to live among this small creation, earth. God, he humbled himself. He poured a little of himself in flesh. That seed that God deposited in that flesh is called Jesus. Emmanuel. God is with us. You get it? You understand it? God is with us. God, he came to live on the earth with us. The big God on a small earth. He didn't come in power. He came weak, weak for us on the earth, weak. And he trusted us when we didn't trust him. He trusted us to raise him on his own word, to raise him on the earth in flesh. I'm trying to help us understand the hugeness of his love for us. Little us. That we matter to God. We are valuable to God. Jesus started some work on the earth, and then Jesus, he left, but he didn't leave us alone. No. The Father, he sent the Holy Spirit. Who is that? Jesus, the Father, all in one. He poured in us. When we believe Jesus, he comes back to us and live in and through us. The big God, he pours out another seed in us. The same power, the same authority, the same love. Without the birth of Jesus on the earth, we can't have God in with us. We have nothing. We are nothing. We're dead. That. sin swallow us up. Free of our sin. Free of death. Do you know that your body will die, but you will not? That you just go right from this earthly life, you go into your heavenly life. You never stop living. Satan tries to fool us to believe we will die, but our bodies, this house we're living in, this body dies. But our spirit continues to live with God forever and ever and ever. My spirit is jumping and dancing. Woo. Woo. John chapter 1, verse 14, it says, "So the Word became human and made his home among us. He was full of unfailing love and faithfulness. We have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's one and only Son, Jesus Christ." Amen. Romans chapter 6, verse 23, it says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord." Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 1 John chapter 5, verse 11, it says, "And this is what God testified. He has given us eternal life, and this life is in his Son." Amen?
Yes.
And the last scripture, listen to this. Just listen. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 15 to 17, it says, "This is a trustworthy saying." True business. This is true business. He says, everyone should accept this true business. Christ Jesus, he came to the world to save sinners. And I am the worst one. Me, LT. I am the worst one. Me. I'm the worst one. See, when you go to God, you have to realize, understand that you are the worst one. If you go to God, say, "I'm better because I didn't do this or that." That's wrong. You can't go to God that way. You have to be totally surrendered. I am the ugly, worst sinner. I am me, it's me. I need the prayer, It's me standing in the need of prayer. It's me, Lord, me. If there are other people who are not worse than you, you're going to God the wrong way. We have to be on level ground, the same. We're all sinners, period. Not some better, some worse. No. All the same in God's eye. It says, but God hath mercy on me, so that Christ Jesus could use me as a prime example of his great
patience,
with even the worst sinner, that's me, then others will realize that they too can believe in him and receive eternal life. All honor and glory to God forever and ever.
Forever.
He is eternal King, the unseen one who never dies. He alone is God. You help me. He alone is God. Amen. God bless you. Let's pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you for your word. We thank you for the truth. Even though there are people who are heartbroken, they're sad. Send us to encourage and lift them up. Show us those people we can share the gospel, the good news that you sent Jesus. You sent your one and only Son, that we all can be free from sin, free from death, live eternally with you, becoming your child, your children. Thank you for your provision, your wisdom. Thank you for our families and friends and homes and clothes. Thank you for our church to worship you together, a place that we can meet, serve, worship for your glory. Thank you. We ask that you put on the hearts of others to send money to help that group of Christians rebuild, even though they haven't in their hearts, they're still living happy, joyful, because they know that you live and you reign. Thank you for your truth. In Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
God bless you.
Thank you.